Guys, it's a problem everyone has early game. You need XP to enchant your tools and all that stuff. But how do we get it without going all the way to the end and setting up an ender or anything like that? Well, today I'm going to show you guys 5 easy, quick ways to get XP. The first and probably the most classic way is to use a mob grinder. And here we've got a skeleton spawner, and of course you can see it's deactivated right now because I'm in spectator mode. But the way these work is that they spawn all the mobs in, and then the water flows them all to an area. So I would recommend doing an array sort of like this, where they all flow down here. And then this wall right here, this is a trick for 116 and 115, that the mobs will belly up against this, and this will force them to go up. And so when other mobs come in, they'll push them along, right into the soul sand elevator, which will send them way up here, and then they'll fall over and take fall damage so you can hit them. Of course, you need to set up this room far enough away that you can set all this up, but close enough that this spawner is still active. Because, as you can see, I had this down here previously, and me being the dumb guy I am, realized that that is too far away to actually get this to work. So that would be inactive when I was down there. Of course, as you can see, I'm in survival mode right now, and I've got my little room. Also, do you like this? These are actually lodestones. They make a good tile-looking floor. Anyway, I get distracted pretty easily. So, over here we've got our skelly spawner, and all those guys are falling down. And of course, we can use our epic sword right here, Skelly Smote, and we're gonna kill these guys just like that. And with Sweeping Edge 3 and Netherite Smite 5 sword, these guys are one-hit kills. Of course, you probably won't have that very much early game, but you'll still be able to send these guys down from at least, I think it's 21 blocks, and 21 blocks should be exactly where it needs to be for them to just be a one-hit kill, even with your fist. And so you can just keep killing these guys, and all this will get picked up through that block because Soul Sand lets items travel through it. And so we've got all these dumb bows and everything, but we also get all this loot. And as you can see, our XP just keeps filling in. So, if we also grab some of these enchanted bows, none of these are very good, so we're not going to want to keep those, right? So, if we go back into game mode, survival, and then we come over here, you can use a grindstone to unenchant these things, and they actually give you a little bit of XP when you do this. So actually, this can kind of be a 2-in-1 XP farm. Of course, the grindstone does not give you a whole lot of XP, but it does help. Every little bit helps at the beginning of a game. I am not going to do a tutorial for this in this video, because this seems like a pretty standard design, and these are pretty commonplace among most Minecrafters. So, this one works really well, and let's move on to the next. This next way to get XP is another common one, but then after this one, we'll move on to some more unknown ones. So if you want to skip there now, just do that. But for this one, of course, we're going to be getting quartz. But now not just quartz anymore. In 1.16, we can actually mine nether gold. And nether gold will also give us tons of XP. And as you can see, it's just flooding in with this quartz. So we grab all that, and we can come back out and try to find some of that nether gold. So if we look around, it's pretty subtle. Oh, there's a piece right there. All right, so if we come over and get this, this will also give us XP. Not quite as much as the quartz, but it's also a good way to get a little bit of gold. And of course, when you're using Fortune 3, that was like 4 blocks of it, and look how many nuggets I got. This next one, although it may not look it, is a raid farm. A simple early game raid farm that we can build pretty simply with just the resources you would have on hand. So, let's take a look at this thing. Alright, so we've got this lava right up here, and this is going to kill our ravagers. And the ravagers are 2 high and 3 wide, I think. So, when they come over here, they're not going to be able to fall down here, but they will hit that lava and die. Whereas all the other mobs, like the evokers and the pillagers and all that, they will just come up, run up here, and try to get to our villagers, which are right there in that glass. And they will try to run up here and think this is a solid block, and so they'll fall down and go all the way down here. And apparently this also works as a hostile mob farm. So as you can see, I am in survival mode right now, and I'm going to show you how this thing works. Alright, so we've got our villagers up there in that, and if I give myself effect, give a civilian bad omen. So if I hit this button, boom, and then a raid is going to start, as you can see right there. So that raid bar is going up. And so all these pillagers and stuff are going to track toward the middle of this village, which is right up there. So I'm going to hop down this hole, and I'm going to come right here. And this is going to be where I'm going to kill these guys. So as you can see, we can come up here, and we can barely see through that right there. And these hoppers are going to pick up all of our loot and apparently some raw rabbit. And so these guys are going to fall down right here, and then we can kill them. The only problem with this is you do have to watch out for vexes. So this is not exactly AFK, but that's okay, I think, for an early game farm. And of course, if you're crouching and you hit these guys, none of the XP is going to go to you. So you have to stand up before you can get that, which is totally fine. And we can handle that. And so now these guys are all falling in, and then it triggers another raid, as you can see up at the top there. And of course, one of the best parts about this farm is that once you're done and you win that raid, then all your villagers that you're trading with are going to give you things. And that's called the Hero of the Village. And so you'll get that effect, and then you can get lots of good trades for a little while and lots of things they'll just throw at you, which is amazing. So let's just see this thing in action. If we set the weather to clear. If I can type. Anyway, there we go. And so these guys are all going to come flooding in, and they will fall right down here, and this water is going to send them all right into the middle there, where they will fall down into that hole, and then we can kill them with our sword. And of course, here we can see the Ravager is coming, and the Ravagers, as soon as they get close, are going to walk into that lava, and there you go. He's going to die. And even we get witches, but the witches still can't see us when we're down there with that chest. And so that is going to work just fine. For this one, I am going to show you guys how to do this, and I might release a separate video on the tutorial on how to make this, and so let's do that now. Alright, for this you're going to want to pick a fairly good sized area where you want to do this, and so I'm going to do this right here. So we'll build up a couple of blocks, not too many, just a couple, and then we'll have, of course, that sand. Oh, and I also forgot a building list. Alright, so here's our item list. We need a bunch of blocks. 3 workstations, 3 beds, 14 slabs, a bunch of trapdoors, not necessarily 64, but we need a bunch. And then we need 64 regular fence gates and 64 crimson fence gates, or the warped fence gates, both of which do not burn in lava. And that is what's going to be right over there. We're holding our lava up. Then we need 2 hoppers, 4 chests, and then of course we need 3 villagers, 4 water sources, and then some lava. Alright, so we're going to start building right here. You want to come up 3 blocks right there, and this is where your villagers are going to be, right on that. And so we'll place out some blocks just like this, and this is where our beds are going to go, just like that. And then over here at the end, we'll have some composters there, and then we'll place some of these on here. These could just be solid blocks, but I thought it would be easier just to shove them all into slabs. And so then we'll come across like this, just like that. Put these slabs over there, and then one more trapdoor right there. And that trapdoor is going to be so this guy right here that's going to this bed can still see it. And then we'll place another block right down here, and then we need to place a water source right in there. All right, we've got our water source in there. Now you're going to just turn this into a big 5x6 block. So we're going to come out just like this, and this is going to be our 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And this is just going to kind of be filled in. You can do this with glass or anything like that, and you're just going to fill all of this in. And this is not going to be super hard. You just need to do all the grunt work. Now, of course, just like we had over there, we're going to place one more layer up. Now that we've got this whole box done, just one more layer up from there. And then also we're going to place our glass on top of that. Now, these do not necessarily have to be glass, but I would recommend it. It just looks more aesthetic, and I did not include that in the building list, so you do not have to be glass right there. But these are just going to kind of go around the edge just like this. Oops, we'll close that again. And then we just need to cover that up. And so that's basically what it's going to look like. Whatever you want to do, you can even add another layer or two here. It does not matter. But then you need to get your villagers in there. So let's grab a villager spawn egg, if I can, you know, type villager. And then we'll place our villagers 1, 2, and 3. They all need to be right in there. Also, I've built this wrong. All right, let's just fix that. We need to just drop this down one more right here, and then this trapdoor is going to go right there. And that should be everything. There we go. We've got our 3 guys in there, and as you can see, they're picking up those composters as their workstations. And so once they sleep in the night, this will be considered a village, and that should work just fine. Now what you're going to want to do is go around the edge of this and take out a space 2 blocks down all around this from 1 block out. You see how I'm doing that? And then we'll take it out just like this and do that whole thing and then clear out the middle as well. All right, what you're going to do now is place water sources in each of these corners, and that is what's going to flow all of our pillagers right into those middle two blocks there. And then we're going to place trap doors just around the edge, just like this. And this is how they're going to detect this as solid blocks, and that's why they're going to fall into the hole and, of course, get swept away by the water. Now that we've got all those trap doors around the edges, we're just going to place these two little fence gates here, just like this, and those will be open. And this is going to be our tube where all the guys fall down. And you can dig this out as far as you want. You can make it kill on impact if you want, but that way you won't get the XP. So I'm just going to go down about that far, and then you'll dig out a little area right here. From there, you're just going to place two chests right here, and you can make those into one, so it'll be a double chest. And then we're going to place, and you need to get rid of those so we can be able to get into this chest. And then you're going to place two hoppers just like this, and then your chests just like that, and we can get rid of that one back there. And this is what's going to be our tiny little area for hitting those guys. And then we can fill this back in with whatever block we're using. And this is pretty much it. And then you just need a tube to get back up to the top. Now we need to place in the lava. And if you're wondering, this looks a little different than over there. This has been made one block up, but it does not matter whatsoever as long as the Ravagers cannot get through there, and this should be fine. So we take our fence gates and just come along like this. And then we're just going to fill out fence gates all along, one under this bottom row of the blocks here, and we'll do that all the way around. Also, two things about that step. These need to be either the warped or crimson fences because they will not burn under the lava, unlike if we did this with spruce or oak or anything like that. And also, you do need to go around and open all of these because if they're not open, then nothing will be able to get in, and we don't want that. We just want the Ravagers to die before they can come in. Now, you're going to do exactly the same thing, except just two blocks out like that, and this is what's going to hold your lava, and we'll just do that all the way around again and open those up. Now that we've got all that done, you're just going to add in your lava, and this should be easy, and you don't have to do these all as sources. You can just figure out how to make it so it's flowing and it'll still fill the whole area, but I'm just going to put sources in since I'm in creative, and that'll be fine. So once we've got all this there, we don't need that. And this is the whole farm completely done. And that is it, guys. And that is how you can get some simple, simple XP. All right, guys. Our second to last design right here is actually furnaces. So this is a super, super simple setup. And we've got all these things working here. So we're going to need some hoppers and all that stuff. And this is a really simple array. But what it's doing is smelting cactus constantly. And the fuel it's getting is using the bamboo. And the bamboo goes really fast, so we should have plenty of smelting power. Of course, you could expand both that farm and the cactus farm and just make this huge. But what we're really trying to do is get the most out of our XP from these chests, or from these furnaces, sorry. So we're getting tons and tons of dye in here, which of course you can use, but this way, we're not getting any of the XP. So we have these levers here, which are locking those hoppers right below them. And that is what's going to give our XP. So if I go into game mode survival, and then we can lock this chest, or lock that hopper, sorry, I said that again. And then we can grab that one piece, and boom. You saw we just shot up in XP. That's how this thing is going to work. And if it's running for over a long period of time with a lot of things going through it, you're going to get a lot of XP. As you guessed it, guys, I am not in a single-player world right now. I'm actually on Realms, and wow, my render distance is very low, but I'll turn that up. And I'm actually on Realms right now, and we're going to show you another farm that I built with some of my friends, and this one is another great way to get tons and tons of XP. This is what I'm talking about, and this is a gold farm. Okay, so this is actually built on the roof of the Nether. We're way up high, so you can't tell. But up here, we've got tons and tons of gold, and that's only a tiny bit right there. But if we come up here, this is how the farm works. So we're going to come right up here, and this is a design by Ilmaker. I cannot take any credit for this. Please go check out his channel. I'll include a link in the description. Wow, that is loud. I'm going to turn that down a little bit. But this gives you insane, insane amounts of XP in very short times. So here, let me grab one of these eggs. We've just got these set up since we have tons of those. I'll chuck this at a zombie pigment if I can hit him. Here we go. There you can see all these guys flooding in, and you automatically get tons of XP because whenever these guys are aggro, they drop XP automatically. so I don't have to do anything. Of course, this is probably more of a farther on game kind of XP farm, but you can actually find fairly simple designs. But as I said, this one is by Il Mango, and I will include a link to his video and his channel in the description. And he is an amazing YouTuber. Please go check him out. He's brilliant in Minecraft, and I just love that guy's videos. Alright guys, I really hope you've enjoyed this video, and I hope it gets you tons of XP and it gave you some ideas on how to make some XP farms of your own. I really hope you enjoyed this. As I said again, please make sure to leave a like if you enjoyed, and if you really liked it, make sure to subscribe and make sure you hit that bell notification so you guys know when I release new content. Alright guys, this has been Civ. I'll catch you later.